would have imagined in those pioneering days of motor racing just how far and wide the love of speed and competition would spread? From Brands Hatch to Jerez to Valencia, the European Grand Prix has made its home all across the continent. And now a new era of this storied race brings us here, to the edge of the Caspian Sea. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. Anthony Davidson joins me today as we look ahead to something just a little bit different. It's quite high speed for a street circuit here, isn't it? Do you think that's going to throw up any unexpected situations?
Well, as long as the teams can keep everything cool, I don't foresee any particular big issues from a technical side of things. I do expect the track to be quite slippery, though. We've not exactly had much chance to rubber in the surface. Any street circuit also comes with its own challenges, so I think we'll be seeing a few mistakes here and there. The smart strategy would be to expect a safety car, I think, especially early on when the pack is bunched up.
Excellent job yesterday. We qualified above expectations. Let's go out there and put in a performance.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Haas in pole position then, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Vettel, Nico Rosberg, and Grosjean, Bottas, Massa, Sainz, and Daniel Kvyat. Ricciardo, Alonso, Sergio Perez, and Hülkenberg, Verstappen, Button, Marcus Ericsson, and Felipe Nasser, Palmer, and Wehrlein, Kevin Magnussen, and Rio Haryanto completes the grid.
race.
Brilliant stuff from Haas today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be Haas picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for coming out on top in that amazing Grand Prix. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Our current points leader extends their lead at the top of the championship after a very good result here today. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going for someone who really punched above their weight here today, and that's Felipe Nasr. He was fantastically quick through the whole Grand Prix.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time, though, goodbye. What a beautiful backdrop to a motor race. We're here in the Styrian Mountains, of course, and they've watched over some cracking races throughout the history of this Grand Prix. Controversy, of course, think back to 2002, but also great joy. Do you remember Niki Lauda's historic home victory in 1984? The Red Bull Ring then, 700 meters above sea level. This tough circuit may only have 9 corners, but they're fast and they're bumpy. It's a true test for any racing driver. We have 2 DRS zones. Watch out for overtakes into turn 2, as the uphill entry helps those trying to be the last of the late breakers steam up the inside. Anthony Davidson joins me to talk you through the action here today at what is quite an unusual racetrack, wouldn't you say, Ant?
Yeah, it's quite an odd layout around here. The thing about Austria is that it's a harder circuit to master than what really meets the eye. On top of that, it's a low grip surface, and that means that your small mistakes end up being punished. And it's very easy to slide wide into the runoff area and lose a huge chunk of time. Luckily, because it's such a short circuit, though, you have plenty of opportunities to perfect the lap.
We've qualified above where we expected to be, so try your best to hold on to this position in the race.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Haas in pole position then, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Rosberg, Lewis Hamilton, and Ricciardo, Grosjean, Bottas, Kvyat, and Jenson Button, Alonso, Verstappen, Carlos Sainz, and Perez, Hülkenberg, Massa, Marcus Ericsson, and Kevin Magnussen, Palmer, and Nasr, Rio Haryanto, and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And with lights on.
Here we go. Oh, what a good start. Made it through the first corner. Oh, got a good run out of the first corner, actually. Not the best second corner. They're all battling each other, so that's good. yellow flag. Oh, Rosberg's had the race. That's fucking great news. He's my rival. Get in. Oh. Concentrate though. Concentrate though. Yes. Kept it. Concentrate now. Fucking hell. Can't afford to shut that. I've got the two Ferraris like up my ass. The rest of the field's quite a distance. Power. Another yellow flag. That was just a lost one. Oh no, he's gonna have DRS!
Cover
the inside, cover the inside. Scrap behind me here. Two Ferraris are side by side.
Now Rosberg is a minute behind me.
A minute behind you? What position is he?
Yeah. They all pitted on the second lap, right? I put intermediate tyres on it. Was fucking bone dry, and then the lap later they were all on super soft. I was like, what the fuck?
Oh god, here come the Ferraris again. We've always been doing this one. Shit. It's not the LS though. It's too far back. This is a great race, isn't it?
Fucking hell.
me space. Oh, he's got me. He's got me. I'll have DRS though. I'll have DRS. Go down the inside. Leave him space. Oh, this is close. Oh. I think I touched his wheel there. Oh, no. No. Ah, he's coming back at me. Break. Power. Oh my God. Right behind me. Good grief, how am I still in first place? Dare put me inside when I'm pitting. Oh, what? So is the Mercedes. Oh, fuck.
What?
I went into the pits just behind Vettel, and because Vettel held me up, because he was going past Hamilton, also got past. Fuck. I also have to overtake the boat, can't you? Which ain't going to be fun. Oh my God, I overcut that massively there. Shit! My tire wear is high. Oh God. That's why I'm struggling so much. Fucking hell, my tires are going. Oh dear. Got one lap. Got Ricardo catching me at a rate of knots. My tires are fucked.
Fuck. Oh crap, I'm gonna do it.
Right.
Oh, there's a fucking safety car queue. Fuck off.
There's two lap cars and we're gonna move it.
Shit, the engine's got sat somewhere. Oh, crap. The most out of the tires. It highlights just how much the team sports really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hounding wheel, of course.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
Oh, I disconnected from Bluetooth. Swear device.
Too good for me today, those three. Unfortunately.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, it's got to be Felipe Massa, hasn't it? He fought so hard and had incredible pace at times. I don't think anyone did better today.